our being here talking for hopefully 12 hours, and all of you except one knows exactly, so I never hope you know. But I have to pretend that you don't know, so I have to just introduce myself as if you never knew me, because also for the sake of the coming. So the weird thing about this event is that there are a lot of things that they don't make much sense. For instance, we have Monkey Sanctuary from one side, monkeys, evolution for the other side, me, current finance researcher, Plymouth University, evolving from nothing to everything, fundraising for rehabilitation project. He got the Nobel Prize. But he doesn't have the Nobel Prize for the third paper, nor the first one. He got the Nobel Prize for the second one. He didn't have the Nobel Prize for the terrible relativity or for the ground and motion. He got the Nobel Prize for the photoelectric effect paper. So it was very small. So that means the universe is already, has moved already very, very far in the process of getting bigger. So far, but we already in the, we're already close to one, close to the density that we don't know is going to collapse or not. Because it has run very quick, and that gives time to us to be already building of tests for us on squad. So that's nothing, just every building or just one excess. There's nothing that this is. But in that stage, when all the tribes and squad will destroy each other, we'll find is that a small amount of antiquar, so the quark appeared, because of this amount that is born from transformation into quark, that was responsible of actually having a lot of, because wherever you are, you have gravity in your body. Your body is kind of gravity, and you are cloud, you have different amounts of body, so that's why you have different mass. Your cloud is having a little gap, and this cloud is getting inside you, getting inside you, and you have the temperatures raising. And if you get a temperature, all of you will get a temperature, now you start to sweat because you get a temperature of, in provinces, from far as the galaxy, you will not go to those quick homes. When you go into a black hole, you go out another black hole. You should call it a white hole, because otherwise you won't be able to go out. So there's a white, a black hole, you go in from one, you go in from the other. And there's a worm in the middle, a connection, this for a worm. And then maybe you can go to, from one part of the rest to another, very quick, just for this hole. That would be interesting too. So that's science fiction development of the solar system. And it happens as well to the Earth. Because how long it took from the beginning of the solar system to the time that we had one? Something like 100 million years. So it takes 100 million years to see that gas. So how do we know this? Well, basically we know this thing studying the rocks from the past. We just see the rocks from the past. And you go down in primitive, in older rocks, and at the moment you find limestone. And then you go before that, you don't find limestone anymore. So that means limestone started somewhere. And started somewhere because for the first time it was possible to incorporate carbon dioxide from the rocks created by those bacteria. And there was a period of when you find this, what's called a formatory. These are secret areas in the world. Sometimes you go there and you find, I don't need to be aware because it's not really many problems for me. I don't need even to synthesize light, upon the light, because I have all this material here. So I'm going to just be there around and eat all this step one. And that's why the fungi appear. The fungi, first time the fungi is kind of, it's another kingdom. It's not a plant, it's not an animal, we don't know it. This now much more terrible, just that the night time from plants, maybe, because they were, at least some of these algae that went out, they just lost their chlorophyll, and then they were all, everybody's in the Jurassic, everybody's just living there very well. The thing is, they would go into the Cretaceous, and some of the dinosaurs start to go down, all the reptiles start to go down, all these huge people of the things like that, that's just stuff they were. Nobody knew what was in the wild, but they were as common. For instance, the plesiosaurs, is this kind of marine or aquatic big reptile, this one dinosaur that looks like the Nessie, the monster of the Loch Ness. But basically, if we have to describe the world, we have this world is a world of grass and beetles. And then all the things, and we are just a small thing, maybe it's already forgotten, but grass are everywhere, and grass is growing everywhere, and pretty well. And the beetles, they do it pretty well as well. They start eating plants. And they find it in Europe as well. They find it in South France, in the nation of Arago. They find the Arago fossils, and they look at on something went up, they moved everywhere, they created, they get bigger groups, they get in a lot of cultures, you use the bronze, you use the iron, and you use the writing, and we